am here to support Occupy Wall Street, and I'm part of the Occupy Vancouver movement.
And how old are you?
36.
Yeah. And so, are you here every day?
Yes, I'm tenting here.
Yeah. And so, what do you do for a living?
I'm a welder artist slash artist, okay. Musician.
So you can do that around your protest activities?
No, because I don't have a welding job right now. So now I'm being an artist.
Oh, I see. Okay. Now, lately, there's been some controversy over whether or not this can stay here indefinitely, as the mayor first had said. Now he's kind of saying, well, you know what? I hope they end it peacefully. He's got an election coming up in less than a month. Then there's Grey Cup activities coming up in less than a month, or about a month. And do you think it lends some sort of urgency to a resolution to this, if there is going to be one?
I'm glad that he's come out and said these things, because we haven't had any contact with him. I've personally invited him on the radio to come down at 7 o'clock. That was yesterday or the day before. He never came. We just keep hearing things, but we're not actually hearing it from the horse's mouth. You know what I mean? So that's a problem. We've just been setting up, and it took us a week to get the internet here almost. So we're just got our infrastructure going, and this is going to take time, because we're building a community right from the ground up. We just came together and started this, right? Just bam, one day. And
how long can you stay here personally, and how long do you think this camp can stay here?
I think we have a right to freedom of assembly, so I think we should be able to stay here for as long as we want.
Now, the appeal court just last week had rejected the Victoria protesters' right to camp out during the day.
You can
stay out over the night, but not during the day.
Oh, yeah.
So what do you think of that now that the highest court in BC has already ruled that this is an illegal assembly?
Is that Victoria or here as well?
BC.
Oh, BC. Well, I guess we'll have to wait and see. Wait and see for the developments, I guess. But I encourage anyone in the mayor's office or politicians to come down and talk to us. There's nothing to be scared of down here. There's food, there's a medical tent, and there's microphones. And at 7 o'clock, that's when stuff really starts getting talked about. And people, it's a full-on assembly. Like, it's great. It's really, really great.
Okay. And so is there one person that the mayor were to come down here, one person that he could talk to, or is there a number of people?
I think the mayor would go straight to the info booth, just like everybody else, and find out what's going on. There's nothing to be afraid of down here.
Okay.
At all.
And so he said that he hopes it can end peacefully. What would you hope?
I would definitely hope for peace. Yeah, that's why I'm here. I don't want wars for profit at all. I want peace and love.
What would be the resolution that would lead to the dismantling of this tent city?
I guess
what would be accomplished?
The next step is to get our demand list.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that's coming. That's what we're working on.
And at the general assemblies, you're working on that demand
list. No, private groups work on their demands. Then they bring them to the assembly. That's as far as I understand.
Okay.
And all the groups come out and speak at the beginning of the assembly, and then we continue on with the assembly and proposals and amendments and all that stuff.
So could you give me an example of one demand that might be being discussed right now?
I heard a list of 26 demands, but that was I don't remember any of the specifics on those. That's just a rough topic.
What about you personally? What would be your number one demand?
My number one demand would be fractional reserve banking gone. That is the root of it all.